One of the most difficult problems when working with CSS is managing specificity. Especially when you're working on larger projects or maybe within a team, you very often very quickly end up in a situation where you have to constantly fight to overwrite code somebody else wrote. We have to constantly think about how specific do I need to write my selectors for my code to actually take effect. Or you need to take an entirely different approach, maybe methodology like BEM, to avoid dealing with specificity entirely. Well, not anymore. CSS Cascade layers allow you to organize your code in layers, and specificity doesn't even play a role between those layers. Let's see how. All right, first thing I want to talk about before we get into Cascade layers is specificity, because specificity is actually a problem that Cascade layers help solve. Specificity would actually require an entire video, or rather an entire course, to explain exactly how it works with all the nuances and all the little details about it. This is too much for this video. I'll just quickly explain how it works in a couple of sentences. Specificity defines when there are multiple selectors in conflict, multiple rules in conflict, which of those selectors is going to take precedence, or rather, which of the code will be applied. If this sounds too complicated, I'll quickly show you how it works right here in the code. So for example, we have an H1 here, and we're gonna mainly in this tutorial be working with this H1 title, and this is our headline right here, CSS Cascade Layers Demo, and I'm gonna show you HTML, and HTML is just an H1 tag with the class of title and ID of title, and you're gonna see why I've added class and an ID in a little bit. So for example, if we were to add another selector here with the H1, and let's change the color to line, this is the first rule of specificity. Selector that comes after in a source order will take precedence and will be applied. Now here we have two conflicting selectors, H1 and H1, and color line is going to be applied because this is what comes later in the source order. Another thing to keep in mind is that classes have higher specificity than tags, and IDs have higher specificity than classes. Those are basic rules. So if we were to add another selector here, let's call it a title, and this is going to again target our H1 right here. And if we set color to maybe yellow, you're gonna see that this selector is going to be applied because this has a higher specificity than the H1, even though it comes sooner in source order, is still going to be applied. And basically, as you can see immediately, the more you work on CSS, the bigger your files get, the more problems regarding specificity you're going to find, and you're gonna have to create more specific selectors, and that can become a really big problem, and teams often very quickly end up in a situation when they are afraid to add or remove something from their CSS. So Cascade layers actually helps us solve this problem. CSS Cascade layers enable you to define which rules will take precedence, and they enable you to do that by creating layers. And the easiest way to think about those layers is in terms of a graphical editing software like Photoshop. So in Photoshop, if you have multiple layers, layer that comes on top will take priority, and the objects that are in the layer below will not be visible, or rather they will be partially hidden. And that is exactly how Cascade layers work, with the one exception, with the one difference. And that difference is that in CSS, the layer that comes later in the order will take precedence, and in Photoshop that is reversed. Layer that's on top is going to take precedence. In any case, let's create our first layer, and layer is created simply by stating the add layer and the name of that particular layer. Let's call it a default, for example, and we're gonna nest all the rules that we want to include into that layer right here. So let's just close that right here, and we have our first layer, which is gonna be default layer that includes all of our code we have defined on this page right here. Let me quickly delete the H1 rules we defined, all right? So right here we have our default layer, and let's create two more layers to demonstrate how this works. Let's call them component one and component two. Layer component one, and we're gonna do layer component two, and into each layer we're just gonna add H1. And in component one, we're gonna say color line like we had before. And in component two, we're gonna have H1 again with the color yellow. Now here we have simple H1 selectors, so specificity would not make a difference even without layers. Our H1 would still be yellow. And what we can do is we can increase the specificity of this H1 right here in our default layer. For example, let's add ID of a title. And as we increase the specificity here, you're gonna notice that our title is still yellow because this code right here takes precedence, or specificity doesn't play a role between layers. So selectors that are in conflict between layers are always gonna take precedence when they are in a layer below. And we can see exactly how this works if we open our developer tools. I'm in Chrome here, and Chrome currently has the best support for cascade layers because it has this beautiful little toggle here that shows you all CSS layers that you have defined. So if we open that, you're gonna see that we defined three layers, default, component one, and component two. And the higher the number here, the more important that layer is, or styles that are defined in component two will take precedence over styles defined in component one or in default layer. All right. And you can see right here, we have layer component two with the color of yellow that is overwriting our color lime and our ID, H1 with the ID of title and with that particular color. So if you're defining layers, you can see right in your developer tools here, when you toggle this checkbox, how your layers are defined and which one is going to take a precedence. And one note about the developer tools. Now this toggle is currently only available in Chrome DevTools. It's not available in Firefox nor in Safari. So if you're working with cascade layers, I would suggest you, at the moment at least, try using it in Chrome DevTools, because you're gonna have a better overview of how exactly your layers are defined. Another thing that I wanna mention here is that styles that are not in a layer or unlayered styles always take precedence over layered styles. So if we were to add H1 right here, let's add color aqua, for example, and you're gonna see that this takes precedence because this is unlayered code. And even if we were to increase specificity right here again with maybe ID, you're gonna see that our code here is still applied. And if we look at our developer tools, you're gonna see that our H1 here is gonna be applied from the unlayered styles, which always take precedence over styles that are in layers. So that basically means that if you're gonna be working with cascade layers, make sure to add all of your code into layers. Otherwise, the code that is unlayered will take precedence and that might create unwanted consequences. Okay, let's remove this code. Another thing I want to show you is that you can add things to a certain layer later on. So for example, we have our layer component one and component two, and maybe later in the source code, we want to add something to the component one layer. So again, we would just write the layer component one and add whatever it is we want to add into that layer, layer component one. And again, if we were to select our title here, we could just do color aqua like we had before. And this will not be applied because our layer component two still takes precedence. Exactly as you see here, we have default layer component one and component two. So component two will take precedence. And as you see in our code right here, component two yellow is applied while H1 is not applied. But if we were to switch that to component two, for example, you're gonna notice that the color yellow is still applied coming from this right here. And that is another thing to understand when you're working with cascade layers, that within a certain layer, specificity still plays a role. So as ID has a higher specificity than the H1 selector, even though H1 comes later in the source order, selector with the ID will take precedence and the yellow color will be applied because we're still working in the same layer. And you can see this exactly here. We have component two layer with the color of yellow and component two layer, again, the same selector, or add a conflicting selector with the color of aqua, which is not applied because ID has a higher specificity. Now, as you see, it's not really practical to work with the layers in that particular way, because if you add more layers into your code, it might be difficult to track which layer is where, which layer takes precedence, or where is which layer defined. So there is another way to actually define the order of our layers, and that would be exactly at the top of our file. We would just say layer and just list names of the layer in the order we want to have them, separated by commas. So we would do default, component one, and then component two. And this would actually define exactly the order at the start of a file that we want. And right here, we're just adding code to the layers that we already defined. And just to show you that this works, let's just switch our component order. So let's say the component one takes precedence, and right here in our developer tools, you're gonna see that lime is applied from our component one. And right here in the list of our layers, you're gonna see that we have default, component one, and component two. And that is not correct, because at the moment, the developer tools still don't automatically refresh the layers list if you change the order. So we're gonna have to reload our developer tools. So let's just do that. And again, let's see if this is now as it should be. Now we have default layer, component 2, and component 1. So if you're changing the order of your layers, make sure to reload developer tools at the moment. You can also use the import statement in CSS to add code directly into a certain layer. And you would create a normal import statement, add import with the URL of a file you want to import. Maybe we want to import component2.css. Of course, this would have to be the actual path to the file you want to import. But for our example, we're just going to show you how it looks. It's not going to actually work as I don't have here on CodePen component2 in my current directory. And we can import that code directly into the layer we want. So we would say layer, maybe component2. So all code from component 2 would be imported directly into our layer component 2. Using import in CSS can have significant performance downsides. I'm not gonna get into that right now, so be careful when you're using that. Another thing that is coming, but is still not available in Cascade layers, is adding code directly into a layer from a link attribute. So you would add that into your HTML. I'm just gonna show you how this would look right here in our CSS because it's not gonna take effect anyway. So you would create a link attribute, rel is stylesheet, URL would be whatever the URL is, and layer would be exactly the layer where you want to import that code. Maybe component 2, like in our import example. Again, this is not implemented in any of the browsers. It might not look exactly like this, but this is supposedly how it should look once it's implemented. When you're dealing with layers, you can organize them any way you want, and you can even nest layers. And you would nest layers exactly like you would expect. So we have our default layer right here. Maybe we could add our star selector into a separate layer. Let's call this our reset layer. And you're gonna see in our code right here that we've created an anonymous layer. A simple thing to keep in mind, you can also create anonymous layers, even though later on you cannot add anything into that layer. So let's name this layer a reset, and let's add all of our other code into a layer called base. These are going to be our base styles, for example. This right here will be our component layer, or let's call it components. All right, and now we have layers components, base, and reset nested directly within our default layer. And we can also define nested layers directly at the top of our element. So we could do default.reset and then default.base. Also, you don't have to define all of your layers in a single line. You can use as many lines as you want. So we can add another line to define our layer order, which would be components, component one, and components, component two. And you can see right here, we have our default layer as we expect and our components layer as we defined right here. But we also have another component one and component two layers. And that's exactly what I wanted to show you. The first time at layer is encountered with a specific name, that layer is added to the list of our layers. Right here, we created our nested layers components, component one, components, component two. And here we have unnested component two layer, which means that this layer is going to be again created right at the level of our default and components layers. So let's add those layers directly into our components layer, or rather, let's move our components layer to top level and add components one and components two layers directly into that particular layer. And I'm just gonna quickly format code right here. And now if we look at the list of our layers, you're gonna see that we have default layer and components layer with component one and component two exactly as we would expect. Another thing to note here is that even in the nested layers, unlayered styles take precedence. So right here we have our layer components with the component selector, which is not nested. So this is going to take precedence over our code right here. If we were to add something like H1 with the color of red, this is going to take precedence over our layered styles again. All right, let's remove this and let's just add this to the separate layer called layer default. So this is gonna be default code for our layer. We have our default layer, our components layer with component one, component two, and default layer. And again, as we have defined our layers right here at the top of our file, our component one and component two sublayers will be defined before in order than our default layer right here, which means that if you want our default layer to be before component one and component two, or rather if we want component one and component two to take precedence over our default sublayer, we should define it here as well. So we're gonna do components default
And then if we reload this tab right here, we're gonna see that we have exactly layers in the order we wanted them. Another thing I wanna show is if you ever wanna revert the code from a certain layer. So in this particular example, I don't want to have a yellow color defined right here when the title class is present. Again, this is a really simple example, so it doesn't really make sense in this case, but just to show you how this would work, if I wanted to invalidate this code right here, I could just do something like color revert layer. This would essentially revert the value of color to the layer before. And you're gonna see it right here. In component one, we have line, which has been now applied to our title because we have reverted the value from our component two layer. Last thing that I wanna show is how important works within layers. Now in unlayered CSS, important works in a way that the last important takes precedence. So if we were to have H1 selector right here, unlayered with the color of red, and let's add important to that, and another H1 with the color of green, and let's add important to that, you're gonna see that the green color is going to be applied because value of green with the important comes later in the source order. And within layers, this is reversed. Or rather, the first important that the browser encounters in your layer is going to take precedence, even if you add important later on in the source order. So let me show you how this works. If we were to have here important in our component two layer, we would see that yellow is applied. But if we also add important to our selector in component one, which comes sooner in the source order, as you can see right here, we have component one and then component two. We're gonna add important here. So line is going to be applied here, even though yellow color comes later in the source order. And this actually makes sense if you understand that important was created with the reason to allow authors to override certain styles. In the case of layers, layer that comes later will always be able to override layers before. So important here actually allows you to override code defined in layers that take precedence. What are the use cases for cascade layers? Well, number one, and most important, you can organize your code better. You can worry about specificity less. You can organize your code in certain layers like we did right here. Maybe you have a default reset style, then you have component styles that take precedence. And whenever you're working with different layers, you don't have to worry about specificity. You're always gonna be certain that the layer that is defined later is gonna take precedence, or rather code that is defined in the layer that comes later in the source order will have precedence over code that is defined before, which will make dealing with specificity a lot easier. This can be incredibly useful when you're dealing with third-party libraries or plugins that you add to your code that come with their own CSS. Cascade layers would actually allow you to define how you want to apply that CSS to be able to ensure that your code takes precedence or doesn't take precedence over the plugin code. So in short, this is how cascade layers work, and this is how they help you manage specificity in your projects. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I will see and hear you in the next video, but in a separate layer.